Coverage of the killing of Osama bin Laden continues now. President Obama says it is a good day for America after the leader of Al-Qaeda was shot and killed almost 10 years after 9/11. Joining us now is Eyewitness News analyst Lieutenant General Reginald Santracchio. You were Adjutant General when 9/11 took place. Your thoughts today, General?
Thoughts are clearly with our soldiers and their families, certainly the victims of 9/11, and I hope this gives them some kind of comfort knowing that justice has finally been served to the world's greatest terrorist.
You know, he was found in a custom-built house compound, you know, no internet, no phone. He used human couriers. Why did it take so long? It was close to where we were looking.
I think it had much to do with the human intelligence that was available and certainly the credibility of other intelligence being gathered, not only from Guantanamo, but from the areas that surround that particular compound. And we need to make absolutely sure that he was there when we launched a military operation against him.
You know, Pakistan is coming into play here. We're hearing from Secretary of State Hillary Clinton that they did help somewhat, but the big question is, how much did they help us?
I don't know that I've heard anything that would suggest that they helped directly with this mission, but I think over the long term they probably did help us to some extent, maybe to the extent of giving us some credibility with the individual we were extracting information from within Pakistan.
After this, what is our relationship with Pakistan?
I think it's going to be a challenge to ensure that we have a good relationship, that we can trust what they're saying, that we know definitively that they have no additional coverage as far as a terrorist concern and protection for other groups that perhaps might be within Pakistan itself.
Now, General, we follow traditional Islamic procedures, washing of the body, wrapping it in a white sheet, and then burying it. Obviously, he was buried at sea. Why did we do this? People are saying because so many lives were destroyed.
I think it has much to do with our respect for the Islam tradition, and clearly, I think this is an opportunity for us to demonstrate we are not at war with Islam. We're at war with those that would use Islam as a terrorist vehicle to conduct violence against the United States.
Well, Iran is weighing in today. They're saying now that the U.S. troops should get out of the Middle East. There is no reason for them to be there anymore now that bin Laden has been killed. Your reaction to that statement?
I think they're clearly concerned that they're next on the totem pole, and they're just leveraging this opportunity to do a political statement knowing that we're not going to leave until all is well in the Mideast.
So what's next?
I think the next thing we have to do is to make sure we stay vigilant and that we're aware that there will be attempts, perhaps not in the next few hours, but perhaps in the next day, weeks, but we will see some reprisal or an attempt at getting some reclamation of terrorism against the United States.
Right, General, thank you very much. Coming up on Eyewitness News at 6, we're going to go back live to Ground Zero with Eyewitness News reporter Walt Buteau with more reaction from the death of Osama bin Laden.